Hi, my name is Lajide Olagunju, and I'm the author of the book, How to Resolve the Conflict, which I'd like to share with you on the screen right now. Yes, this book, How to Resolve the Conflict. And this book is the textbook for the lecture you just joined. It's a lecture series called How to Resolve the Conflict. And it's a daily lecture series we broadcast every day of the year to help improve our individual and corporate ability to resolve conflicts. As I always say, conflict is the biggest industry in the world, and so we need to know how to engage that conflict, that industry, sorry. So what we do essentially is read the text, and then we then have a discussion. Right now, we are discussing institutionalizing mediation, institutionalizing mediation. And I already explained why in the previous, one or two previous lectures. If it's biggest industry, then it ought to be institutionalized, you know, the same way other industries that are not as big and industrialized, you know. And why? Because institutions make things work better. It's easier to get what you need, the skills, the facilities, the manpower you need to get things done, you know. So mediation is a skill if it is institutionalized. So I was saying that mediation is an industry, and we need to be able to have access to it, and that happens through institutionalizing the process. And talking about institutionalizing, we talk about what the states can do, the governments, what they can do. Now, let's talk about what lawyers can do. As you know, lawyers are the foremost professionals in the dispute resolution industry. And so they ought, in my view, ought to be at the forefront of promoting and institutionalizing mediation. Let's read and then have more discussion. Lawyers' associations could also lead in the promotion and provision of mediation facilities. Australian lawyers are pioneers in this regard. The American Bar Association and the Law Society in England have done a lot of research towards the promotion of mediation. In-house solicitors, company secretaries, legal advisors ought to consider introducing the directors and managers of their companies to the concept of mediation. This will help to deal with both external and internal conflicts, thus ensuring a firm management control of business disputes and avoiding bad publicity. That's a lot, but I think it's pretty straightforward. As I said, a lawyer like myself, we are the foremost dispute resolution providers. And so we must look for best practice. And one way of doing that is to support the institutionalization of mediation so that the skills are readily available and people don't have to go too far to get the skills they need to deal with their conflicts at all levels, marital, business, whatever, government, what level, at whatever level, you know, wherever there's a conflict. If we institutionalize mediation there, then it will make life easier for people. We make them improve in terms of conflict instead of decrease. My strong argument about conflict that it is only a measure of the state of relationship. And so those of us who are lawyers ought to be very sensitive to that, that dispute conflict is not an end in itself. It just helps parties, our clients, to know that it's time to improve on our relationship. And so the skills to make that happen is what mediators provide. And so it's great for a lawyer to also be a mediator. And probably in some situations, it's great for the policeman to be a mediator. It's great for people in various industries to be mediators, at least to learn the skills of mediation. And whether they are lawyers or not is the duty of lawyers to make sure it happens. And I know that it's not just in those places I've mentioned, England, Australia, US, other places, France, Nigeria, you know, they're promoting mediation because it is indeed a superior method of conflict resolution. And I think that those who are the foremost professionals in it, lawyers, ought to be provided leadership. I'm not sure I'm seeing enough of that leadership. You know, I've been in the mediation work for about 3 decades. And I think I expect to see more. Mediation, like civil litigation, ought to be a standalone course in all law schools. You know, it must be possible for lawyers to help deal with conflicts as they come, as amicable as possible, you know, as amicable as possible before people are made to go to court. The court ought to be the last resort, the very last resort, even for lawyers. You know, yes, we are trained to go to court, that is true. And it's great being in the courtroom. I've been going to court off and on for 33 years, you know. But the truth is that courts don't necessarily, not to say really, resolve conflict, you know. Well, at best, they manage it. They provide guidelines on who is right, who is wrong. But that's not the purpose of conflict. Purpose of conflict is to trigger an improvement in relationship, to take the relationship to a higher level. And so we lawyers must be conscious and sensitive to that and not to use occasions of conflict to disrupt relationship instead of building them up and making them stronger. You know, conflict is simply the parties telling each other, well, we need to bake a bigger cake. You know, we need to enlarge our course. We need to do bigger things. You know, and then so conflict should be seen positively in that respect to move them forward and not allow the relationship to degenerate. As I said here, in-house solicitors, apart from the private legal practitioners, in-house solicitors, those lawyers who represent government and other big corporations, ought to, legal advisors, ought to introduce directors, non-lawyer directors and managers, you know, of their organization, corporation, and government to the concept of mediation. They need to do that aggressively. It's an urgent task that must be done. This is something that ought to be done like yesterday. Everybody in your organization, if you're a lawyer, everybody in your organization ought to master or to at least understand what mediators do, if not master the skills of mediation itself. And it doesn't really take long to do a mediation training. You know, you could organize mediation training for your managers and directors, you know, in batches, you know. And before you know it, everybody in the organization is trained, and that improves relationships in the organization and with external people, clients, customers. And what does that do? It boosts your business. It boosts the business of the organization that you act for, you know. And of course, that improves your own, improves you in every way, your earnings, and the organization's any other stakeholders in the organization, in the industry, they do better. You know, and of course, what happens if all organizations and governments, you know, have improved access to mediation, to amicable, effective conflict resolution, to this superior method of conflict resolution? What happens? We have a better world. Because what is the world? It's the sum of all of us, all our organization, all of us as individuals. So I make it a very strong point that lawyers ought to promote the institutionalization of mediation. I give several examples of lawyers who have done that in the past, you know, in various countries. And I think that that's a right step in the right direction. But the point I'm making is it is not enough. We lawyers ought to do more to promote amicable dispute resolution. And the foremost dispute resolution, amicable dispute resolution mechanism is mediation. So we should see it as our number one primary duty to promote its institutionalization at every level of society. Thank you so much. And please subscribe, press the red button that says subscribe on the screen, and that will be great. We'll be very happy if you do that. Read the book, How to Resolve a Conflict. It's available on all Amazon outlets. If you have difficulty getting it, just send me a word, send me a message. And of course, what we are learning is for practice. The whole idea of this broadcast, of this presentation, of this initiative, How to Resolve a Conflict Lectures, is to make you a better mediator, make you more skillful at managing conflicts, beginning with your own and also that of others, at home, in business, at work. Thank you so much. And we'll continue tomorrow. This is Lecture 58. Continue tomorrow in Lecture 59. Bye for now.